Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. Welcome to another train video. It's been a little bit, but back here at the Clinchfield Railroad with a look at the General Electric U36C. Seven of these were made for the Clinchfield Railroad back around the 1960s. As you know, or as you may know, this is a classic scenario taking place around the 50s to 70s around the hilly regions of Virginia. Have a pair of these 3600 horsepower road switchers at our disposal today. Just going to do some collecting of some loaded coal cars up around here at Elkhorn City. And we're just going to make our way towards the very end of the line. So in the meantime, just going to move forward a little bit, because we just got to position ourselves to collect our cut of cars. And then we'll be on our way towards the end of our line. As I did mention earlier, mountainous terrain here in Virginia, or this scenario. So with that, monitoring our speed is going to be key to acing the scenario. No timetable that we have to reach, but I think the grading should be consistent throughout the route today. But who knows? May have some surprises in store. We're just going to stop right here towards the end of the main line. We'll be making our move to collect our cut of cars. A little bit further. Like a millimeter short. There we go. First cut completed. Let's go pick up second cut on the adjacent track. Alright, there's cut number two. Just gonna go a little bit further up the track, appears, and pick up cut number three. And there's cut number three. So now we're going to make our way towards the end of the scenario. Should be 20-something odd miles. Back in the cab now. I think we're just a little over 10 miles away. Has slowed down to 15 miles an hour from 30 just as we cross through the next checkpoint. But probably going to stay in the cab for most of the ride until we're there. Hope you enjoy the ride. So just some observations for those that may be interested in purchasing this engine for the Clinchfield Railroad scenario. It's a pretty responsive engine. And, you know, most of this route, or most of this scenario has been on an uphill gauge. Braking, you know, even with the assistance of gravity, it's been really responsive. And the engine does have enough power to sufficiently make it up to speed and control the speed as well at idle. So, fun little engine so far. If you're interested in getting this locomotive for the scenario, definitely would recommend it. Oh, let's see here, Rex turn, lead unit, blah blah blah, in the hole of Delano. Okay, so, just we'll have a train off to the side. That's it, nothing major. Alright, so once we get past Delano, it'll be 2 miles to Rush Main, then another 7.5 till we get to the end of the line at Caney Storage. Alright, almost to the end now, about 5.5 miles to our stopping point at Caney Storage. There's our speed limit of 15 miles an hour coming up. So start dialing some braking. Use locomotive brake 2, as well as the handbrake. And should be able to get down to 15 miles an hour, no problem at all. There we go. Got right down to it as we're pulling onto our siding. So we're starting to come to a stop right here. Hope everybody enjoyed this look at the General Electric U36C for the Clinchfield Railway scenario. Be sure to leave a like and leave a comment if you'd be interested in seeing any other trains from this scenario or just from Train Simulator in general. And as always, be sure to subscribe, hit the notification bell. And as always, thanks for watching.